forever.
Gather round and get cozy. Listen to sketch comedy. Funny setups and situations to spark your imagination. You cannot see all the wigs these characters wear. And it doesn't matter if you're in your underwear.
Hi, I'm John Milheiser.
And I'm Zed Kutzinger.
And welcome to Radio Shorts. Hey, Zed, I just got back from a vacation in New York City.
John.
And I went to town on pizza,
John,
ice cream,
John, what
Broadway.
Are you, what are you doing?
I'm bantering.
Yeah, the thing you said we can't do.
Right.
Feels pretty good though, right?
Yeah, it does. Maybe we should banter. To be continued in the season finale of Radio Shorts next week. Anyway, enjoy the show, folks.
Radio Shorts.
Look, it hurts me to say this. I'm not sure exactly how to say this.
What? What is it?
I need to end this. End the relationship.
What? Why? I thought we had something.
Me too, but people change.
I can't believe this. You're breaking up with me at a cat cafe?
I don't know. I thought, you know, you love cats. I thought it would make it more relaxed
no.
or something.
No, Chuck, it won't do shit.
Okay, well, you just have to criticize everything I do, even how I break up with you.
Well, this is ridiculous. I mean, I'm so sorry. I want you to be a better person.
Do you have any idea how condescending that sounds?
Oh, I don't fucking care.
Of course you don't care. You don't care about anything but yourself.
Oh, you want to talk about selfishness? You want to pull that thread? Let me remind you that you cheated on me.
We worked through that!
Yeah, biggest mistake I ever made. I should have just ended this with you then and there.
Well, you did. Get down. Well, you didn't.
Because I loved you, Frank. I loved you more than you even knew.
Well, if you loved me, why didn't you tell me more often? I have feelings, too.
Oh, I didn't realize you were so insecure that you needed to be told that I loved you every day.
Well, I am. I guess I am. I guess I need to hear it.
Don't cry.
I mean, I think part of it is the allergies. I'm very allergic to cats. I tried to love you, but all I felt was you pushing away.
No, I wasn't pushing you away. I loved you.
Loved?
The day you violated my trust, I just don't think I could go back to what I once felt for you.
Don't say that. Please don't say that.
I have to. I know this started with you ending it with me, but I think I'm on your side now. I loved you, but I think the separation is the best thing for both of us.
Don't go. Please don't go. Oh, man, you're really stepping on cats. It's a lot of cats.
Hey, Mom. Hey, Dad. I'm home.
Hey, home. I'm George.
Good one, Dad.
Hey, honey. How's that crossword coming?
It's pretty easy.
Easy like Sunday morning. Lionel Richie.
Yeah.
Hey, watch this. Domino's Pizza. This is him. Jesus Christ. What hospital? A pin. Give me your pin.
Yeah, here. What?
Oh, my God. Okay. Thank you. My brother's dead.
Mark died? Oh my God, what happened?
He was biking and a car hit him. Domino's Pizza. I know, Kathy, I know. We heard. How did you hear? It's on the news? Oh God. It's on the news. I need to get a hold of Mom before someone else does. I miss him. God, I miss him already. Thanks for calling, Kathy.
I can't believe this is happening.
Hey guys, I'm home.
Hi, home. I'm George. My brother's dead.
Uncle Mark died? Oh, I don't understand.
Dominoes.
Okay, the plane has crashed. We can't change that. Now we need to focus on surviving, finding supplies.
Yes, look for warm clothes, blankets, and liquids. We need to stay hydrated.
And food. We must eat.
We have nothing to eat. The hull was ripped in half, and all the food was sucked out with it.
What are we gonna do?
Remain calm is what we're gonna do.
I know what we could eat.
Yeah?
Yeah. We could eat each other's asses.
We're already starting to lose our minds.
What? No, no. Eat each other's asses.
That's what I thought you said.
If you did, you'd bend over and let me get a lick in.
I'm sorry, but what the fuck are you talking about? Eat our ass? We aren't the Donner Party.
No, 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 no. Not eat, eat. Eat, eat. Like eating pussy. But not the front, the back. The back pussy. That's the ass.
We've only been stranded for an hour.
What will we gain from eating each other's asses?
Nutrition. Plus, it feels really good.
Yeah, there's no nutrition in the ass.
That depends on whose ass you've been chowing down on. For me, I only eat the finest of ass. So yeah, I'm getting all my vitamin S.
Vitamin S?
Yes, the S is for ass. The thing we've been talking about eating?
This all sounds really painful.
Oh, I won't bite. Just gently lick the circumference. Just like this. Ooh. Ooh. Scrumptious.
Oh, there you guys are! Hmm?
Carrie, what is wrong with your ankle?
I sprained it. The pain is bearable. But I saw Harry, my husband, die.
I know what could help.
Don't say it.
I could eat your ass.
What could that possibly do?
Distract from the pain.
I would be willing to try anything.
See, let a woman make her own decisions. You can be next if you like.
I'd rather die than ever let a creep like you eat my ass.
What if she wants to eat your ass?
I mean, I would be open
to... I don't want to eat your ass.
See? She doesn't want to eat ass.
What? No, not your ass. The Z-Man's ass is what I desire.
Hold up.
Wait. Time out.
Yup.
You're the Z-Man? The world's greatest ass eater?
Yes. And it looks like we have plenty of time for me to eat all of your asses.
All right, guys, as you can see from this chart, these numbers are up and these numbers are down. Why does it smell like dog shit in here?
It does smell like dog shit.
Where is it coming from?
The vents? Maybe.
Or it could be coming from this bag of dog shit.
That's your bag of dog shit, Randy?
Yep.
Then the smell might be coming from that.
Yeah, the dog shit smell is definitely stronger here as opposed to back over by my chair.
I'd say there's a strong chance that the smell is coming from that bag. Thanks, Randy. Any other ideas?
Maybe someone stepped in dog shit?
Oh my God, that would be terrible. Everybody look at your shoes.
Oh.
Okay. Yeah.
Nope, just my feet.
Mine smell bad, but I didn't step in dog shit.
I didn't step in dog shit either, but I did pick some up, put it in this bag, and carried it with me to work today.
Well, we're narrowing down the field. Good work, team.
Wait, I gotta say, I think the smell's coming from Randy's bag of dog shit.
Yeah, I'm beginning to lean that way, too.
Okay, all right, slow down, guys. I found in business, it's best to take in all the information first, and then deduce the best solution.
Well, did anyone bring a dog into the office today?
No.
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 I own a dog. I didn't bring him with me today, but I did bring his shit right here in this bag.
Now that I think about it, I also smelled dog shit earlier.
Where, Dana?
Well, when I was carpooling in with Randy. Aaron, you were there.
Yeah, it was Dana, Randy, that bag of dog shit, and me.
Yeah, and I also smelled it when I took the elevator.
Randy, were you in that bag of dog shit also in the elevator?
Hmm? Oh, yeah, sure was. Had it in my briefcase.
Great. We're getting really close here, guys. Any other ideas besides Randy's bag of dog shit?
Maybe someone farted?
Well, that would be just rude. Did anybody fart?
No.
Oh, no. Yeah.
No, I've never farted.
If I may, I felt a fart when I was putting dog shit into this bag, but, you know, that was, what, hours ago?
And where is that fart now?
Oh, it's still inside.
Hmm.
Well, I think the answer is clear, guys. Let's take this meeting to the break room.
Oops, almost forgot my bag of dog shit.
Radio Shorts.
Hello, and thank you for flying Jet Black, where we mean high fashion. Please check the suede seat pocket in front of you for this season's hottest safety manual. Be sure to look in it if you want to get safe. As we leave the gate, make sure your tray tables are properly put away, and that all posing is done in the upright position. If you're seated in an emergency exit seating and are unwilling or unable to perform the required functions, join the club. That shit's hard. Please place all Louis, Fendi, Gucci, and Prada bags in the overhead compartments, and all Old Navy bags put in the bathroom so we can shit on them. If cabin pressure changes, oxygen masks will drop from the panels above, and so will a Henry Bendel gift bag. If this happens, pull the oxygen mask towards you until the tube is fully extended. Place the mask over your nose and mouth, and then begin to breathe normally. Then, go through the gift bag. There are 6 exits on this flight. None of them are labeled. You just have to know about them. We'll be having celery for dinner. And as we come to the cabin for a final looky-loos, be sure to tell us who you are wearing. Finally, sit back, relax, and enjoy Jet Black.
Shorts.
I love this part of the song.
Me too.
How low can you go?
Go lower, Kyle, lower.
A little bit louder now.
Oh, no, not yet, Chris. It's still the softer now part. This is the best part of dancing at weddings.
Yeah, my baby loves to boogie down. Ow!
Woo!
What's happening?
We've been dancing low for a long time.
Just give it a second.
Okay, we're still getting softer, you guys, so shh.
A little bit softer now.
Holy shit, look at Kyle. He's still getting lower.
Yeah. How does he do it?
I just do it. I love dancing low. I love it.
Is it weird that the song hasn't changed for a really long time?
Not to me. This is the best.
No, this has been going on for longer than usual.
Maybe it's a remix?
All right, finally, here we go!
I don't remember the song switching back to the softer now part.
Huh. What if the song never ends? What if we're trapped here forever? I can't take this. I can't.
Pull yourself together, goddammit.
My thighs are really sore. Let's just belly crawl out of here. Follow me.
Dun, 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 here comes the me. This is fun, you guys. Come on, dance low with us.
We are never getting out of here.
Wait a minute.
Break Up at a Cat Cafe was written by Arie Cohen and performed by Avery Monson, Jocelyn DeBoyer, Alana Johnston, and a bunch of cats.
Domino's was brought to you by the sketch team Onassis, written by Alex Scordellis, performed by Frank Garcia Howe, Don Luby, Benjamin Apple, and Cassia Miller.
Z-Man was written by Zod Kutzinger and performed by Mark Schroeder, John Milheiser, Jocelyn DeBoyer, and Holly Prazoff.
Why Does It Smell Like Shit in Here? Brought to you by the sketch team Onassis, written by Jason Sines, performed by John Milheiser, Don Luby, Frank Garcia Heil, Cassia Miller, Emily Altman, and Jason Sines.
Jet Black was written and performed by John Milheiser.
Shout was brought to you by the sketch team Onassis, written by Alex Scordellis, performed by Don Luby, Frank Garcia Heil, Jason Sines, Emily Altman, and Cassia Miller.
If you like this episode, please subscribe, rate, and review Radio Shorts on Apple Podcasts or your favorite podcast app.
And be sure to tune in next week for the season finale of Radio Shorts.
And hey, tell a friend about Radio Shorts too.
Oh my God, please tell them.
And while you're at it, follow us on Twitter and Instagram at Radio Shorts Pod for behind-the-scenes photos and videos.
Forever Dog.
This has been a Forever Dog production. Executive produced by Brett Boehm, Joe Cilio, and Alex Ramsey. For more original podcasts, please visit foreverdogpodcasts.com and subscribe to our shows on Apple Podcasts, Spotify, or wherever you get your podcasts. Keep up with the latest Forever Dog news by following us on Twitter and Instagram at Forever Dog Team and liking our page on Facebook.